Possible ptosis, right eyelid drooping over the last 5 months. I am growing very concerned as I've noticed that my right eyelid has started drooping considerably over about the last 5 months or so. This was definitely not the case a year ago, and it seems to be getting worse. I'm not diabetic, and I have no major health problems. I'm growing very self-conscious as it can appear quite pronounced, especially if I'm tired or not trying to compensate in photos, and can even make me look slightly cross-eyed. Any help?
Thank you for your question. So you've noticed in the past 5 months that the right upper eyelid is drooping, and with the photos you submitted, it's clear that the right upper lid is at a different height compared to the left. So when someone comes to our office with a new onset of ptosis and has no history, and this is where it's very important for you to at least look at your old photos. A lot of times we've seen people who have had more noticeable ptosis as they got older actually always had a small degree of ptosis that somehow they compensated for, and the ptosis got a little bit progressively worse. But for a physician, a new onset of ptosis always requires some type of medical and neurologic workup. And it's not that we're rushing to diagnose something serious, but we have to rule out some possible things that could be related to ptosis as an early sign. So my recommendation is you bring this attention to the attention of your medical doctor, or see an ophthalmologist, or see a neurologist. I mean, you need to bring this to the attention of a physician so that the appropriate medical workup can be done and you can rule out any of the things that may need to be dealt with before you consider doing any type of corrective procedure. So, that being said, and assuming that everything is fine and the diagnosis that we typically have when someone has adult onset of ptosis will be something called levator muscle dehiscence or levator muscle attenuation. Now, what this basically means, and usually it's a little bit older than your age group, but certainly it can happen in someone younger, is basically the muscle called the levator muscle, like the word elevator. That muscle has a tendon called the aponeurosis, and it tends to thin and sometimes detach. And when that happens, the eyelid droops. So we routinely perform a procedure called a levator muscle advancement. Something falls back, we bring it forward. And this procedure is done typically under local anesthesia with light sedation so that a person can actually cooperate. Now, as strange as it sounds, and a lot of people come to our office and say, please, I don't want to know what's going on and that kind of thing. This muscle is so sensitive in terms of its activity. It's not difficult to make someone numb. It's kind of like going to the dentist. You get a little local anesthetic and you're fine. But the sensitivity of the muscle is that just a little bit of one way or the other, a millimeter in one direction or the other, can cause the eyelid to look too open or too low. And not only that, we want to maximize the appearance of the symmetry in terms of the contour, the height, and the shape. So all of those things we benefit from by having in adults. We'll have the person actually open their eyes during the procedure, and I'll routinely actually sit them up. And then we'll all go in front of them and we'll look and obsess and see if I need to do any adjustments. And typically we have to do a little tightening or loosening of a stitch, then, or maybe the addition of another stitch. You know, that's a very dynamic process. And once that's done, we're able to let the patient relax and sleep a little bit more. And 95% of the time, it's fine. The person looks good. 5% of the time, there is some degree of asymmetry that needs to be addressed. We call that enhancements, whether the eyelid is a little too high, a little too low, or if there is any other contour and other things that require refinement. It's good to understand that it is normal for there to be a 1 to 2 millimeter difference between the two eyes. Very few people are really that symmetric. But in our brains, when we look at people, if we see it, if it's within the 2 millimeters, then essentially we've got, we see it as symmetric. So essentially, you can anticipate that once you've had your medical evaluation, that you've really reached, you can have the procedure as I described, a levator muscle advancement. So to summarize, I recommend you have a medical workup first. And once that is clear, then consider levator muscle surgery or ptosis surgery. I hope that was helpful, and thank you for your question.